People, the Moski is here and this is some Chroma Squad. Now, we did the last episode, it was against a flock of birds, I think, and the barrel guy. It was very hectic, but we didn't get the spoils of war because I messed up with one of the objectives, but that's not going to be a problem now, because I'm intending to go here full gear. We have a marketing option here, I haven't checked it out, and it's mad folks. They are a bit old school, but they get the job done with a 15%+ of audience per episode. I could probably end up losing some money here, but let's see what happens if I click on the income conversion rate. It says 125 fan power. No, let's not screw with this yet. We go to the episode. This could probably be a bit weird if I don't. I mean, I have some sort of time limit here. So, director instruction, perform a team attack with 3 squad members, defeat all lame bread crumblers in 4 turns. Sounds a bit tricky. Fatally terrorize the city, celebrate some squad. Did I already read it? I don't remember. Now, where are we? I love it when you use the teleport effect for no reason at all. It's just too much fun, isn't it? Not Mikon? Ha ha ha! And I almost forgot, R2PO, you have a dentist appointment today, right? Yeah, in a few moments, Mr. Lionel. Then I'll have to leave, I'm sorry. Okay, so no problem, we'll make this as quick as possible. And what's going to happen now? Let's check it out. It's time for the minions to get on stage. We got bird person, bird people, roar, and the squirrel people who also go roar. And suddenly a very human-like alien-esque figure joins the scene. We find an alien, fatty alien. No! You're not supposed to join us right now! We haven't found your hiding place yet, what? I'm sorry folks, I'll pay more attention next time. Okay, that's some mid-spoiler, I suppose. A few more minions to the scene should make up for it. And now we got a lot of squirrels, but I only need to beat the bread crumblers quickly. Let's get rid of these monsters, they are around all around us. And don't worry, Yoshimitsu, this should be easy. Go, Chroma Squad, go! Go, go, Chroma Rangers, and now we just have to beat this quickly. I can't chromatize yet because I need more audience. The way to get audience here is probably to attacking, I suppose. We have to defeat the bird person first. Can not become flank this guy? No, she cannot. So what's going to happen here is that Mr. Lionel here, he's going to make sure that everyone else can reach these guys. Now, Yoshimitsu, you're here and prepares your teamwork so that this guy here can defeat this bird in one hit. Just like that. Now, not Mikon, you're going to be here and attack the squirrel. Oh, Mr. Lionel, that's nice. Now we get the chromatize. I'll use it on the next turn. You know what? Let's do this. We put in danger El Diodorino, but he's going to help the whole team get rid of the birds. Yeah. Hey, you're in my costume. Oh boy, you guys are very lame. Just a bit more. I just have to endure these guys. The problem are the birds. There's just too many of them. Oh, El Diodorino is going to be very bad. This is a very bad position, but if I put El Diodorino here, you're not El Diodorino, damn it. Still, let's chromatize from here, and now everyone, flee. Light, camera, chromatize, there we go, Chroma Rangers. Now, just put you here for now because of your special skill, which you cannot use. Oh boy, now Nanikon is probably strong enough to beat these guys in one hit, if I use the sword at least. Let's see, test that theory, and yeah, she's strong, she's like the tank of the team. Now, can you do it too? Let's see if you can, and it touched it. Alright, El Diodorino has not been moved yet, so you probably better here with some teamwork in action and work with me. You are dead and the objective is complete. That wasn't so hard, was it? Now you're going to be in problems here, Yoshimitsu. But that's okay, because you can take a hit. No, you can't. You're the fastest one here. You probably are not glass cannon, just a scout. Yeah, you're the scout. You'd have a... What's your class? I forgot. No, that's not a problem now. Yoshimitsu here is going to paralyze everyone on this corner. Stunning pose. And there you go. And now you get to free the scene. You coward. You have nothing else to offer to the team right now, so you're just going to kill the squirrel here. Well, almost kill the squirrel. You here, Mr. Lionel, are going to prepare for teamwork. So do you. Teamwork now. And El Duderino to the final strike. There we go. Both objectives have been complete. Completed? Yeah. Oh, what's going on? Oh, you got hit. They're no longer paralyzed. Not a problem, not a problem. Just get out of the way. Who needs healing here? You're going to wait over here. Wait for them to come to you. And let's just beat him now. There we go. You stay right here and prepare teamwork and teamwork. Not exactly doing anything, but you just have to wait until they come here. And now everyone here is in troubles because C3PO's, well, R2PO's skills can hit everyone. Multi-shot here. You fell into my trap. You're going to kill this guy? Not Mikon is going to go for the strongest one on the punch. Probably you. And you're not the strongest, but yeah, you'll do. Is that? Now, for our leader here to do the sword and destroy the squirrel. And then finally, you're not... Oh, El Duderino! How generous of you! Let's do it! A slash attack instead! Your two instructions have been completed! What do I get from this again? I forgot! Maybe more fans! We should continue this story in another episode. For now, I'm off to the dentist, take care everyone, and he's gone. To be continued. Okay, that's nice because we're already almost not three quarters, that's well. Wait a second, we may use R2PO's absence to build a new story piece. Yeah, like R2PO was kidnapped by Fat Alien. Yeah, where did Fat Alien go? This will be gold. And well, actually proceeding with the story. We should get to a different position, the audience will think we're at a different part of the episode. Wait, are you serious? Good idea, Yoshimitsu, everyone move and let's get to the new positions. Is this thing still going to go on? Fat Alien kidnapped R2PO, then Chroma Squad reached its warehouse so they could get their friend back. And it suddenly appears. The alien again? You shall never see R2PO again! Oh, squirrels and turtles and bears, this looks like a zoo right now. R2PO is in good hands. Ha ha, yeah. Then someone else joins the set studio using the teleport effect. And zoom, and who the heck are you? Yeah, right, who are you? And my name is Thomas Dahl, I'm Galax Silver, the 6th Ranger of the Galax Rangers. We are responsible for maintaining galaxy-wide peace! And how honor! And this intergalactic monster is a threat to us all! I thought you were just barging into our studio! What the? But I'll definitively take that, your line was too great! Welcome to our show, Thomas! Alright everyone, keep rolling! Are you bloody serious? Galax Silver, it's nice to see you here, a fat alien kidnapped R2PO! And say your last words of best creature and limitless potential Galax Silver! Zip. Alright, we got a Silver Ranger now. My Galax Saber is ready to strike you down. Come on! What is going on here? I'm confused. Well, we have to more direct instructions. I'm already at the time, so I'll have to check this second part of the fight on the next episode, because for now, that's it! Thanks for watching, and Moski is out!